This is the Harpoon Classic Commanders Edition video tutorial. This tutorial can be run with either the Harpoon Classic Commanders Edition demo or the Harpoon Classic Commanders Edition game. Start either the game or the demo, whichever you have. Once the Select Battle Set window appears, select the Western Pacific Battle Set and click OK. Select Scenario 7, Thanh Hoa Bridge, and review the orders. When ready, click New Game to start. Under the Select Game options, turn off Normal Maintenance Failures and turn off the Auto Formation Air Patrols. Pause the game by reducing the time compression to zero so that we can have a chance to rearrange the maps and review our orders and prepare ourselves. Since the action takes place in a very small area, we're going to turn off the strategic map, don't need it. And we're going to cover up the stupid advertising at the bottom by moving windows on top of it. Move the unit window to the side and resize it, and move the group window here and resize it. We'll zoom in on the units that and the area that we'll be fighting, and we're going to change the game options. Change the colors so it'll be more easy to identify and spot icons. We'll leave the other settings unchanged. Change the staff options. And we will change range circles. Now, with the game paused, we'll examine our units. You see we have an air base in Thailand. We'll check for the ready air. There's 12 B-52 bombers ready to go, armed with 2,000-pound iron bombs. We have an air carrier group. AAC has 3 ships in it, and there are 72 planes and 6 helicopters all ready to go. We'll examine the aircraft. We have Vigilante Reconnaissance Aircraft, Sea King Anti-Submarine Helicopters, Viking Tankers, Hawkeye Airborne Early Warning Aircraft, and our Heavy Attack Bombers, the Intruders. Our Light Attack Bombers are the Corsairs, and our Phantom Interceptors. Because the orders state that we should not be using too many long-range standoff munitions, we're going to leave all the loadouts as they currently are. And we'll reread the orders. Our target is Thanh Hoa Bridge, which is denoted by Unit ZXB. Unfortunately, this is an error. ZXB, it should actually be ZYB. Check our order of battle. These are our different assets. And we can check individual units. We'll zoom in. We can check what the Robeson is. Under the database, check for the sonar capabilities, radar, weapons. And we can check for the Bainbridge. once we familiarize ourselves with our units, we can also check all the active units. There are only three active units. We don't have any subs, so no active classes appear. And these are the aircraft that are found within the scenario. We can check all active aircraft if we'd like, but that just leaves a huge list. So we'll focus primarily on the units found within the scenario. Now that we know what our objective is, destruction of ZYB, we will unpause the scenario by starting the time compression. First off, I'm going to launch a pair of airborne early warning aircraft, and I'll send four fighter escorts. Can't land them. We'll launch another pair. Another one. And launch four. Escorts for her. I'm sending the airborne early warning aircraft out first because they move the slowest. Increase the time. And she's in the air, so I'll pop loiter, and now we'll launch her four escorts that we missed before. We'll zoom in. First group is out and moving out, and we will turn on their sensors and make sure that everyone is flying at high altitude. The four interceptors are up, and we will join them with the other group. There's the Hawkeye, and we will join four Phantoms to it. We can send them off. And we'll turn on their radar and ensure that they're at high altitude. Okay, we'll increase time compression. Once there's a little ways out, I'm going to launch two Vigilante reconnaissance aircraft to bracket the target and give me an idea of, as soon as one of the aircraft launches, it starts detecting surface-to-air missile radar, radar, anti-aircraft artillery battery radar, radar from the airbase, mobile radar, and a Soviet-era intelligence ship. So we've launched one, we'll continue, and we'll launch one for the other side. Again, hoping for some cross-fixed so that we can triangulate the targets. We'll examine some of our targets. We know from the radar emissions that the target is somewhere within this uncertainty zone. We don't know exactly, but from according to the strength of the radar signal, the best guess from the staff is it's somewhere in here. We can also select, well, there's a few more. Now we've detected a few more air interceptors, fighters, more artillery, anti-aircraft artillery, and then more interceptors. Okay, we'll continue. We can select one of these units, and we already know it's a surface-to-air SA-2 missile battery. This is an unknown contact, and another surface-to-air missile battery, and another unknown contact, and an unknown surface group. We can select the individual unit for this group. We'll pause the game for a moment. And this is 005. We can see the corresponding unit in the unit window. It's the our friend AGI Primori. We can display more from the database function. Check out her sonar and the weapons she carries and their firing arcs. We can also click on her and hit the full display, and we'll know if she's her weapons are active or not. We can also click on the interceptors. They are suspected to be in this uncertainty zone. Don't know exactly where they are, but somewhere in there is where they're estimated to be. We can check on her and the weapon she's carrying. It looks like she's in an intercept configuration. Now, we know that the surface-to-air missile batteries cannot be over water, so they're most likely somewhere in this part of the uncertainty zone. Now that we've examined a few more of the enemy, we just don't have enough information to locate them precisely. And we'll zoom out and we'll continue the game. In our message window, we can see at what time the contacts were made, what we think they were, a fighter, and from which unit was detecting them, and by which method. We'll increase the time compression just a little bit now. Now that the planes are approximately 48-50 miles from the carrier, and these are 80 miles from the carrier, I'm going to launch my strike planes. Now that the recon planes are approximately 50 miles ahead of the carrier, it's time to send the strike group. We could send a whole bunch of small groups with different functions like suppression of enemy air defenses, or SEED, or escorts, but I'm going to gamble and send all of them at the same time. So we're going to launch an attack against the bridge. And I'm going to put all the strikers in one group. This means that the planes that are a little bit faster, like the Phantoms that move at 500 knots, or the Corsairs that fly at approximately 490 knots, are going to be held back by the intruders, which only have a speed of 415 knots. The advantage of this is that they'll all arrive at the same time. While the strike group's launching, we can examine we notice that the neutral surface group, OCS, has finally been confirmed as neutral, and it's our old friend AGI Primori. As we can see in the group window, there aren't any individual enemy air units, but we can see them in the unit window. This means this is Air Patrol ZZ01, means that it is still attached to Air Base ZZ. And if we examine another one, this is ZZ02, and it doesn't show up in the group area, means that it's still part of the air group, airfield ZZ. We can take a look at the individual plane through the database and take a look at what weapons it might be carrying. It's probably carrying an intercept loadout. We can check out another. And we can check out individual units. As the planes are closing, we can see that the uncertainty zones are being reduced. We'll increase a little time compression. Our first SAM unit has been fairly well localized. It's in a very small area. Not perfect, but close enough that we have a pretty good idea. Here's one that's very well localized. It's our mobile radar. And our strike group is now fully launched. We're going to make sure that they are all at low altitude. Now that the vigilantes are over 100 miles away, we're going to launch another one. To support the first ones. We can see from our vigilantes that the loadout is a patrol loadout, which consists of a drop tank and an ECM unit, which is a jammer. Although the jamming range is only 10 miles, it's better than nothing, so we're going to order one of our vigilantes to turn on sensors, and that's how jamming is turned on. We're starting to get better, more precise ground information from the SAM unit. Now we've localized an SA-2 battery. And we'll add a little compression. Our first notification that ADA is flying into enemy anti-aircraft warfare range. If we don't know which one is ADA, we can always have the show. That'll flash the unit. If we still want to, we can always select it. We can issue orders to it. And these are the current orders we can modify, but we're just going to keep the current orders. And the first enemy unit has detached from the airbase and is now moving to intercept our inbound units. As you can see in the group window, we can intercept it by hitting the intercept button. The staff will show us which aircraft don't have a mission at this time. So we could double click on one of them, and the asterisk shows up here, meaning that this aircraft is now assigned to intercept that new contact. Or we can click on the next one and hit the intercept. That means this one is now assigned to intercept that contact. But I don't want either one of them, so I'm going to turn them off and click cancel. We're going to slow it down a little bit, zoom in. And as soon as the contact ADA, ZHA is within radar range, we're going to fire on it with the Sparrows. We're going to add one more, see if we can take them down the first time around at long range. And now both of them have been shot down. We can flash it. Yep, they're down. We'll hit continue. And a second radar contact, ZFA, is moving to intercept. When they're in range, we're going to fire on them too. just outside, so we're not going to close and attack. We're going to let them do the closing and attacking. So no. And now we should be in range. No. Now we'll add 2 onto this one. I want to make sure I kill him. And both frescoes are shot down. We'll continue and add a little time compression. See the notice the uncertainty zones have virtually disappeared to most units. Now we have very good solid contact on several anti-aircraft units and one large surface-to-air missile. The airbase radar is being jammed, or may not be the airbase itself, but one of the units within the airbase is being jammed, as we can see by the lightning bolt symbol in the corner. And there are several air patrols up, but they haven't moved to intercept us. The vigilantes are providing excellent coverage, and they've pretty much localized all the active ground air defense units. Looks like a lot of SAMs, and they're receiving jamming. Okay, now this is air unit ZZ03. See, it's getting pretty close to 20 miles, 19 miles from the vigilantes. We still have some maneuvering time. Now it's time to alter course. We're going to edit this one. We're going to insert a waypoint just to make sure we avoid that Air Patrol ZZ03, and we'll do the same for the other vigilante. We're going to insert a waypoint to take us just outside his range. And we'll add a little time compression. Number of new contacts have shown up. Continue. Okay, we now have a new airborne contact that's detached. Looks like it's moving to intercept either the radar aircraft or the vigilantes. Slow it down. Our strikers are still moving in. Let's see which one he goes after. That looks like the vigilante. Okay, now's the time to start maneuvering hard. We're going to move the vigilante. We're going to insert another leg. We're going to see if we can't dodge him. We're going to increase speed to full power. Let's see if we can get away from this guy. Another one has moved to intercept the other vigilante, so we're going to also evade. And go to full throttle. Within range of our Phantom, so we're going to try and shoot this one down. Add 2. And both frescoes are down. We'll reduce speed on the vigilantes, and we will replot a course. Head back towards the target. Oh, need to evade again. We'll just clear all, and we'll pull away. Now they're both getting into phantom range, so we'll add, let's hope that 5 will be enough to kill it. And we're out of long range missiles for the second group. Nope, wasn't enough, so now we're gonna have to waste the rest of our missiles on it. Tried to be cheap and it cost us. So we're going to replot our course and reduce speed. Now our Phantoms no longer have long-range missiles, so we got to be really, really careful, because the Hawkeyes cannot evade. Not even the slow missiles, not even the smallest of missiles. So we'll fire. We're going to need to fire at maximum range. Pull away. If he gets in close to the Hawkeye, he'll slaughter him. Another group has detached, going to full military power. He's moving to intercept. Now it looks like they know where we are, so we may as well activate the sensors. We're not hiding anything. Now we can check on the other airborne radar aircraft, and we can see that YY has moved into intercept position 6 miles away, so we're going to fire on him. Moving at such a high speed, if he gets into the into range of the radar aircraft, that could be very bad news. So we're gonna move away from him if possible. We fire 6 missiles at him. Hopefully that'll be enough to bring him down. Only one was shot down, so we need to re-engage. Next salvo brings him down. At this time, we don't need to bring our precious radar aircraft any closer. As well, neither do we need to bring our vigilantes any closer. As we can see, most of the land units have been localized sufficiently. So now they're just going to jam from a safe distance. And a roving air patrol from ZZ-14 has moved close enough. We're moving in towards the radar aircraft. Got to keep an eye on them. They're 10 miles out. And he's within range now, so we'll engage airbase ZZ. These are all the air units in airbase ZZ. And he's run and evaded them, but we're out of missiles, so it's time to go home. The vigilante has attracted unwanted attention. Time for him to go home. And the AIA has been detected by radar. Let's see which one that is. That's our backup vigilante, so turn on the radar. We're being chased at 610 knots, so let's discourage him by going to afterburner. Our other radar aircraft and vigilante have also attracted attention. Now it's time for them to go home. Being driven off station, and we know our strike planes have been detected, so we'll turn their radar on, and since they're already detected, we may as well go up to high altitude to increase the radar horizon. Maneuver to evade and we'll shoot our way in. One plane is running on afterburner, so we better slow it down. He lost his pursuer, so I think we can bring him back in. Two more intercepting frescoes have been shot down. Good. We're plowing our path, as hoped. See if we can shake our pursuer by going to afterburner. Yes, and the AI has decided it doesn't have enough fuel to chase. So we'll return to cruise speed as the wolves converge on the strike group. Strike group in range, we'll shoot it down to. Another interceptor is moving in on the vigilante. Okay, let's see if we can't lose them. The strike group is now clear to the target. And The Fresca has shown up within visual range of the Vigilante. So now it's time to run. And increase speed to afterburner. We've evaded the Fresco, but we still need the jamming support, so we need to slow down and come back to the target. Okay, pause the game for a moment and select our target. The SAM-2 unit will be attacked. We'll try to suppress it. We could probably kill it with all eight standard anti-radiation missiles, but we don't need to destroy it. We just need to keep it from firing. So we'll fire four at them. Hopefully we can knock out the radar, and if the radar is out, it will have no guidance. Here's a second surface-to-air missile unit. And we're almost in range. And notice that the range ring just reduced. That probably means that our SAM is on the way, has been fired. So we're going to fire all four. Hopefully we can shut this one down too. As we close on the bridge. We're 22 miles out, and our range next weapon range is 21. As we can see from the message log, the engagement, some of the anti-radiation missiles have been shot down, but many of them have missed. As long as they're shooting at the missiles, they're not shooting at us, at my planes. Miles out. We're still 15 miles from the bridge, and our next weapons that are in range are 10 miles, so we just have to be patient and close. Unfortunately, here's a good example. Looks like the SAM unit is back up. Let's take a look at it. We did get a hit. It's damaged to 8%. Looks like the weapons mount was hit and the sensor. We can take a look and see if the radar seems to be offline. We're hoping it is. If the radar is offline, he can't fire. Miles. And they're going to catch our last radar group, so let's see if we can fire back. Nope, still just out of range. Just out of range. Okay, the bridge is now in range of the standoff munitions. We're going to fire the four walleye missiles at it. And we're going to continue to close in because Now the next weapons we have are rockets or bombs, and their range is 4 nautical miles. We're 10 miles out, so we have to suffer through it. We're going to shoot down our pursuers, hopefully. And both of our pursuers are down, so now we have a clean run home. We'll zoom in on our strike. The Walleye missiles are 3 miles out at medium altitude at a speed of 528 knots heading towards target ZY00, which is the bridge, being followed by the rest of our attack group. If the Walleyes miss, they'll have to put their bombs and rockets on target. Our rockets are now in range, so we're going to allocate all of them. That's the primary target. Often these rockets are used for defense suppression, such as anti-aircraft units, but the primary goal is to knock down that bridge, so we're going to fire everything we can at it. And more AAA units are being found. These are the anti-aircraft units. And the bridge has been hit for 60% damage, but we have to destroy it. So now our planes are in range. We're still 1 mile away. We just lost our first intruder to anti-aircraft. With the loss of our first intruder, we're 1 mile away from the bridge. And we continue to close. We're in range of our iron bombs, and we decide to expend all of them. And the bridge is destroyed. With the target down, it's time to leave. We'll be running for home. Don't spare. We're burning gas all the way. And we continue to take losses from anti-aircraft artillery on the egress portion. And victory is awarded. We can check the status. For the loss of 3 aircraft, we destroyed 28 enemy aircraft, 1 base, or the bridge. We damaged 2 air defense, 1 fixed, 1 mobile. This concludes the Harpoon Classic Commander's Edition demo tutorial.